Hey, welcome back to EDF6. This place doesn't... I don't seem to have a place I can fucking hide. Shit, man. That was kind of the whole strategy in that last fucking video. I think I might be fucked for this one. With no beehives holding the damn buildings up, this might not be so bad. Here, y'all go out there and figure out where motherfuckers are. I'm going to knock down some fucking buildings. See if those bombs do anything. Actually, I know they don't. They don't do pretty much anything at all. There we go. Try just fucking hitting the crowd. That's what I need to aim for. Or trees. Whatever. Fucking fine, I guess. I don't think my bombs fucking found anything. Those robot bombs didn't do shit. And these motherfuckers have crowded around my people, but I will be hitting and killing my people right here. There's like no doubt in my mind that this right here is me killing my own fucking people. I'm trying to just hit them, and oh, come on. Goddamn assholes. And I missed.
I need to reload.
This guy sure screams at me that he needs to reload a lot. He can just fucking do that. He doesn't have to actually say it. It's not a verbal command. I know that it doesn't seem like I necessarily know much about guns, but I actually have a pretty decent comprehensive understanding of them. And this may be science fiction, but you don't have voice commands tied to reloading. Your magazine is a manual magazine, you stupid asshole. I have a growing concern that this mission is going to have a bunch of these motherfuckers climb up out of the fucking ground. I'm looking at the radar right now, and there's just not that many of these fuckers left. But we didn't really do anything there. So it feels a lot like, to me, these motherfuckers are not the entire army we have to face. One hit on that guy. Then I'm going to call in my depth crawler. All right. These motherfuckers, I think we're easy. It's been a week. It's been a week. I have played games that pissed me off, and I have played games that didn't. But it does mean that I am probably not in full remembrance of what the hell actually happened last week. So I think this thing is actually capable of fighting these motherfuckers. But I ain't real guarantee on that. Oh, I picked up health. I shouldn't have done that. We won. We killed everything. This was way too fucking easy. Yeah, that's what I fucking thought. That very loud booming noise. It feels like to me, if they start swarming me like this, then I can like actually hit. Okay. I can maybe hit them in like small groups with this thing, and maybe they don't just actually swarm me with 100% of their forces. That does not seem like that was actually working though. The ground is still just too damn uneven. This thing is useful. Very useful. It's the only reason I'm fucking alive right now. But still, uneven terrain kicks the shit out of this thing's usefulness. I know. If I grabbed a fucking mech, like an actual walker, it would be a lot easier. But I know that if I do that, if I'm going to have the points to summon the motherfucker, that's where the problem comes in. I don't know how much I'm actually getting. Y'all are kind of segmented out. I think I could probably do this fight. I could probably do this fight a little bit different. But I'm not going to. Snipe one motherfucker, knock down the building in front of me, knock down that shit, knock down this wall, and then shoot everything over there and try to hit something. If anybody actually like gets me, I'm kind of fucked. So Just try to hit him with as many explosives. Or not explosives. Those things are like fucking dropping a rock from space. All right, I fucked up. I think I summoned everybody. I heard... Hearing that fucking screeching noise is the alarm that says we're going to come and kill you. So, feels like maybe either my buddies or I freaked out that last little crew of them. This mission is not so hard, though. Like, I'm out of my Gatling gun. So, I might change my mind on this being difficult now. The mission has ended up being pretty easy up to this point. All of my friends are dead. But that's to be expected. They are mostly fodder for the slaughter. I am still picking up health boxes when I shouldn't be. But I mostly just have those guys... Yep. I have them all get fucked up, but they're not dead. They're all just kind of taking a breather right now. And they sit there, get shot. I get shot less, and then... I end up having fewer of them to fight at a time. So I don't really mind them not surviving through all of this as easily as I did. Also, none of them have a fucking walking tank that they can just summon, which I feel is kind of unfair. All right, I'm gonna do the same thing I did last time. I'm gonna hit the closest motherfucker, and then I'm gonna run the fuck away. I don't want to try and actually fight all of them at once. And I'm just trying to lure in some of them. And I'm hoping that my guys don't lure in the rest of them. But I bet they will. Bet these dumbasses think that they're supposed to shoot everybody. These guys also fucking shoot from way too damn far away. God damn it. My large caliber thing, I just obviously missed. I missed every goddamn one of them. Son of a bitch. Well, it does look like nobody attracted the rest of the army. So I'm not fighting like a huge number of them all at once. So that's fine. These guys are supposed to be annoying because they can climb up on buildings like the frogs and shit. But that doesn't actually bother me all that much. Them climbing up on the buildings is kind of annoying if you're like stuck in an alleyway. So... As I've said before, you should not watch me for, like, tutorials and tips and shit like that, because I ain't nearly good enough at games for that shit. But if you watch and there is something you can take away, I like to try and put something in each one of these EDF videos especially, where I didn't just embarrass the shit out of myself and I did say something useful. That one's just one of them. It gets kind of frustrating. I'm going to pick this up. But I'm doing it for that guy. It gets kind of frustrating to fight these motherfuckers sometimes, but mostly it gets frustrating if you're in an alleyway and you're fighting even like a few of them and you're looking straight at them because they know how to flank you. They know how to get around the side of you. And once they do, they climb up on a building, look down at you, start shooting those damn hooks at you. So I guess that's the one tip for the video. Be real fucking careful with these guys, because they ain't hard to fight, they ain't hard to beat, but they are very annoying when it comes to urban warfare, which is kind of like the main point of this game. It's very urban warfare. Look at that. My people are fucking alive somehow. I don't know how the hell they're alive, but that's what these fuckers are shooting at, and now they're shooting at me. God damn, man. I'd like my drones to come back so that I can actually fucking hit them from a distance, but that ain't happening fast enough. So I'm ignoring that. They are going to swarm me. Shit. I tore down the buildings because that was a good decision. It was smart to do that. I'm going to take credit for it as a good decision because I need all of this, like, I need all this space to see these motherfuckers. Yes, they need to be able to see me too. Their whole thing is like long range stuff, but I've got this tank that walks fast enough. They actually don't hit me as often as they could. And I need them to crowd together so that I can fucking hit them with these powerful cannons. Also, the Gatling gun is far more effective if I've got them bunched up together like this. because that means I don't actually have to aim it carefully, and these streets are fucked up. I'm getting them in these groups. I'm glad they chased down my buddy there, because that actually gave me a bit of a respite from them chasing me down. I think I'm going to stop shooting that gun. It was doing a good job. Now I need these guys to get, like, kind of close to me so I can take them out one by one. And, yeah, this street is fucked up. There's one enemy that's kind of far off, and I'm hoping that one stays far off. That way I can kind of walk through and pick up any of the fucking drops that they did. Because I can use those. Get the remaining androids. That is exactly what the fuck I'm doing, jackass. This guy, he annoys the shit out of me for a bunch of different reasons. But I also hate it when people give me orders that I was already doing. I'm only on my second tank, so I'm guessing I probably have enough points to summon another one. In the off chance that this motherfucker is not the last one, I think I probably have enough that I can get a new one. I'm hoping that doesn't happen. I'd rather just shoot this asshole when I'm done picking shit up and then be done with it, but I don't know. Kind of lucked out that there were any weapons left. I'm glad that it wasn't just all health boxes, but that is a health box. It's the last one. I don't actually need it. This motherfucker. Don't dodge my shit. You're the last one. Just die, asshole. Thank you. Well, all I got from that one was a couple of upgrades, but one of them is actually better as an upgrade than what I was given by doing higher level shit with the Ranger. This limpet sniper does more damage. Okay, you turned around real quick there, bud. That limpet sniper actually does more damage. Oh shit! If I'm actually like specific about this, I can do a shitload of damage. These guys actually die. That is not what my experience was when I was playing through it originally with the Ranger. Because you're not supposed to get through these guys quick. They're supposed to be really tough. I wonder if I could just... The sniper drone comes back to me pretty quick. I wonder if I can just snipe these guys to death. It should only take a couple... It only takes a couple shots. These aren't the biggest ones. The game... I know, spoiler, whatever. The game does throw bigger... robot assholes at you eventually, but they're big enough for right now, and I'm doing a lot of damage for right now. That's the important thing. The damage that I'm currently able to do to the current enemies. I'm gonna get up on top of a building. Is this like a taller one? Goddamn fucking camera. I really, really hate this camera. This is actually a pretty flat top building. I think I could do some damage from up here. I always did like playing sniper in games. I don't like the limpet sniper not being able to actually zoom in. It's long distance, but I can't zoom in with it. Maybe there's just like a special... No, that doesn't work. I can't zoom in with the limpet sniper. And because I can't zoom in with it, it's not actually much of a sniper weapon. It doesn't really bother me too much. But it would be far more useful if it zoomed in like a sniper weapon tends to need to. I can throw these off the damn building. Oh, shit. Knock my ass down. All right, well... You also climbed a fucking building, so I guess I can't be too surprised by that. I think this one ought to be easy if they don't send in like a shitload of reinforcements. It's always a possibility that they do that, but it does seem kind of unlikely in this particular scenario. That motherfucker deliberately charged at my people. They're not even actually a threat, man. You went at the people who couldn't do anything to you. That seems like a deliberately shitty choice. I don't know how close any of these assholes are to me right now, because I can't see over the top of anything. I'm trying to knock out some buildings so that I can actually see. The one that I could see was up on top of a building over there. I didn't really want to attack that one. Feels like if I shoot one that's too far away, a bunch of them are going to come at me all at once, and I don't have the reload speed, I guess is the best way to put it. I don't have the reload speed to actually fight that kind of onslaught. I think I might have accidentally aggroed the last two of them. They were standing off to the side for a while. And then some stray explosion or something fucking hit them. So that means I need to get into this motherfucker and hope that my people are a good distraction. Because I don't know how many of them are going to show up in like a second wave. If there's going to be a second wave, I don't know. But I definitely want to pick up as much shit as I can before that kind of thing happens. I'm all out. There's only one left, and I'm not going to shoot at that one at all. This one was getting kind of close to me, and it was bothering me. But I'm going to go and pick up all this shit, and then I'm going to fight that asshole, and I'm going to hope, because I don't know how likely it is, but I'm going to hope that this was the entirety of their group, and that they expected, because these guys hit really hard, that this was hard enough on Inferno, and they don't send another fucking group of them at me. Now, you know something? I mentioned earlier, this mission was a bit difficult when I started. It was, but it was also a really good early farm for me, because if you have anything that does a decent amount of damage and you're playing on hard difficulty, you'll knock them out. You'll win the fight. And it won't be impossible for you. And they all drop a bunch of shit. That must be the end of it. They're telling me to destroy the... Yeah, hell yeah. I didn't get a whole bunch of shit from this, but I got a decent amount, I think. Yeah, that's some stuff. I don't care too much about the electromagnetic prison, but the guard capsule S2, that one has, it's not enough of an upgrade for me to care all that much. Well, shit, that would have been nice to actually have a lot of. If I leave it right there, you don't get any spoilers for anything. I forgot that I'm supposed to do the outro during the mission, if at all possible, so that I don't get a bunch of spoiler shit here. I'm done for the day. I've been playing for over fucking 50 minutes at this point, and I got two missions. That's the best I can do. I hope you enjoyed this one. I hope you come back for the next one. I'll see y'all later. Bye.